There is no other facility in the world that provides this size for testing with the movable floor and all other sensing and instrumentation equipped with the digital tools that complement the physical modelling.
The National Buried Infrastructure Facility opened 2022. And it's one of several facilities that were built under a UKCRIC scheme, which UKCRIC stands for the UK Collaboratorium for Research on Infrastructure and Cities. And as such, 14 founding universities got together, lobbied government that we really need to have a collaborative research capability in the area of infrastructure and cities. And as part of this, we built the National Buried Infrastructure Facility at Birmingham. Because the idea was that each institution really expanded their strength, and our strength at Birmingham has always been on buried infrastructure, our pipes, cables, sort of geotechnical engineering, anything to do with the soil. That's where our strength was, and as a result, we built NBIF. So the sectors we've dealt with are probably mainly the civil engineering construction industry, but in its broadest sense, so from the supply chain to the contractors to the consultants. Anybody who really wants to break ground has got assets in the ground, and wants to place something on top of the ground, because the ground is potentially the highest risk in any construction project, but also provides the biggest opportunity, because we can look at ground source heat pumps, all these alternatives that we want to use our underground space for. One of the key facilities that doesn't exist anywhere in the world is our movable floor. This was built in collaboration with MTS, which comprises our 50 actuators. But we also have a number of other actuators to simulate our surface loading, both as static as well as dynamic actuators. And if you're wondering why did we choose MTS, because we actually did have experience with using their systems in the past. So therefore we were confident that they were sort of our delivery partner to develop this together.
We'll start at the very top of the building. We have the chillers. In essence, what the chillers do is when our HPUs, when our pumps get too hot, the chillers will chill the oil down. Working our way down, we have the control room on level one. It controls the whole of the MTS system. So it'll go from the cabinets to the control room, and we can then make different profiles, different procedures, and we can pretty much do anything we want to with the actuators. We have high definition cameras, so whatever's going on, we don't need to be at that place. We can be in the control room and everything can be done from there. So we use at the moment a system called AeroPro. It's a very good piece of software. Once you're used to using the software, you can pretty much do anything you want on there. In the HPU, we have three large HPUs, hydraulic power units, and they power the whole MTS system. So when we have all 57 actuators running at one time, we require the whole set of three running at once. This is why it's essential for the chillers on the roof to keep the oil cool, and it's a very, very large power unit. So we have the flex test controllers, and where the actuators are electronically plugged in, they all go to the flex test controller, which then in turn goes to the PLC, and this is the brains for the MTS system. Under the floor in NBIF, we have hard-lined pipes. They will come straight from the HPU units, and they will go to each individual section on the floor where we can, essentially it's a plug and play system. So we can move our seven actuators, which are above head, we can move their HSUs to any point that's selected on the floor. So it's quite important that these hard lines, they go to areas where we can access and we can reach, because the test hall is very large and we will have different experiments happening at different times. So in NBIF we have a very large pit, 25 metres long, 10 metres wide, 5 metres deep. In the middle section we have 50 actuators. These 50 actuators, they can all move independently. They have a travel of around 300 millimetres, 150 up, 150 down, and we can simulate ground movement. When we look at things like heave and settlement in the real world, we can try and replicate that in NBIF. So we can move the actuators in a certain profile and to see what the ground movement actually is. this is not only for ground movement, but this is for anything to do with underground. So pipe work, how will the pipes react underground? We can put cables in there. We'll put the sand in, we'll fill it up in layers, and we can use our sensing technology, our actuators, determine what's going on actually underneath the ground.
When we do an experiment in NBIF, we always equip it with advanced and state-of-the-art sensing technology. That data that comes out of the sensor then are used to build a replica for the experiment, a so-called digital twin. And the difference between the digital twin and a standard static numerical model is that the digital twin can get data in a live format, which then allows you to build your simulation in real time, which then allows you to tell about the status of your experimental setup and make changes or stop it or update as and if needed. We also use machine learning to extend beyond the current scenarios in order to predict what happens under various different conditions, be it environmental, be it physical, be it mechanical.
We are simulating the frequent passage of HS2 trains, our high-speed trains, over our pipe. It is absolutely invaluable to us to understand the exact stresses and strains and deflection when the various scenarios are played out. There are very, very few other facilities in the world that can achieve that.
I always think of NBIF as a big Meccano set, which you can adapt. And if we can do it at smaller scale, we will do it at smaller scale. We don't have to use the large scale. What's important is that the end product, the data we get out of these experiments, is meaningful and helps address the question. We have done a number of experiments to date. These range from looking at pile foundations, where we constructed the piles using two different methods. We've looked at displacements of a tunnel. We used a pipe to simulate the tunnel. We have tested some structural beams. We are planning to do a platform test where we look at platforms for construction vehicles on quite soft material. But we've got plans in the future where we're trying to look at tree root soil interaction, so something completely different. But because we have got the scale and we've got a way of loading it using our actuator system, we can do this in our facility, and that couldn't be done anywhere else because we can do it in the field, but we just can't control it in the same way as we can do in NBIF.
We've already seen a lot of interest, not just in the UK, but from around the world. Examples are governments, policymakers, designers, consultancy firms, contractors, and generally practitioners. We are seeing massive growth on urbanization. This comes with its own challenges, and this facility allows us to provide the right people with the right information at the right time.
I think everyone is just really impressed. It's just that wow factor here. And everyone that comes by, they have loads of ideas, what they couldn't have had before.
What really excites me is that we can do something that ultimately feeds into industry and changes the way we do things. So whether that's sensing technologies, whether that's methodologies or processes, we will be able to support industry to make a step change and really change things for the better. Being a civil engineer, I have a civic responsibility, and we can really use NBIF to its fullest potential for this.